Everyone, I'm Purge and welcome to another video. In this video I'm going to show you and talk about the update that was released today, that the Jadinko Lair. It is gay name mate. That was not very nice. And his name is Fellblogger. Okay. That's a good start. Anyway, so, unless you're not talking to me, I don't know, doesn't matter. Anyway, we're here at El Carid, and I'm going to show you a good way to get the Jadinko Lair. Now, if you go to El Carid, go to the glider, talk to the glider person. That person dancing beside me, you've seen my videos, and he decided to follow me. So that's fine. So we go to the glider again. If you go to the Kramja glider area, now this here is way east of El Carid. Way east of El Carid. Way east of Shiro village, and right south of here is the Herblore habitat. But in a minute I will actually show you how to get here. There's a bit of a faster way of getting here. There's a shortcut you can actually do. If you come down here south, there's the entrance, the main entrance to the Jadinko Lair right here. There's some NPCs you can speak to right here. So you need to do this to take advantage of everything in the lair. You will need 83 wood cutting, 83 fletching, 83 fire making, and 80 slayer. So that's the minimum you require to actually go down here. And you definitely need a hatchet. You definitely need a hatchet. If you want to take a tinderbox, you can. I'm pretty sure you need that as well, although you may not need one to light fires in there, but I would say take one anyway. Take a tinderbox, take a hatchet. Ignore the money. I thought I needed to buy some juju pouches, but you don't. And here is pots. I took pots because you need to kill stuff down there. Obviously, though, before I go any further, I will say, just like my previous video on the Dragon Defenders, it is very... Thank you. It is very, very crowded down there, because obviously the first day it comes out, and obviously I'll go into the new Abyssal Vine Whip a bit later. But let's go in there and let's see what it's all about. And it may be a bit laggy down here. Pretty nice graphics. If I get rid of that for a moment. Here we are. This is the first chamber. It's made up of about four chambers, this cave. And it is very, very, I wouldn't say very large, but quite large. There's vines here. These jade vines here, they're in every one of the outlying chambers, and I'll show you the area in a moment. They're in every one of these, and you can chop them down for woodcutting XP, so let's do that. Let's chop a vine, I get XP, you chop it again, I get a curdy root, and I'll explain what a curdy root is in a minute. You can, if I just drop that, you can, and you actually get four of them per time. So if I cut them again, I got another curdy root. Now, you can also, from these, you can also get straight roots. I have a hardened straight root right here, and I'll explain what that does in a minute, but you can also get straight roots from these jade vines. So you cut these, you get straight roots, and you get curly roots. Also in this chamber are the mutated Jadinko babies. They're level 90, and they require level 80 to at level 80 Slayer to kill. So that's that chamber. If we head into the very to the central chamber, now right here are fire pits. What you do is you add curry roots to the fire pit, and the interface comes up here, it says add all curry roots, and you get quite a lot of farm making XP for doing that. I'm adding all my curry roots into it, and I'm getting about 378 XP per curry root, so it's actually pretty good. With that fire, you can actually put straight vines in them, and they will become hardened straight vines. So you put the straight vines in the fire, and they will become hardened straight vines. And I'll get to what they do in a minute. If you come further into the chamber, like so, you'll see the huge Jadinko Queen, very, very majestic, and you can chop a healthy jade root there. Now, in the back of these, as you can see right there are mutated jade roots. Let's cut these. Cutting away, cutting away, cutting away. Takes a while, I'm sure. Indeed, a long while. And I've just got 140 XP for that, and I've just got another mutated vine witch stack. Now, what you can do with these, as long as you have 83 fletching, you can combine a hardened straight root and two mutated vines. Wow, I need to fletch the shafts first, and I don't have a vine to do that. How unprofessional. Sorry about that, folks. So, okay, I'll just go into what you can make. If you fletch a hardened straight vine into shafts and add two mutated vines to it, you can make a range weapon. And that range weapon is called, I'm probably going to get this wrong, so I apologize in advance. I believe it's called a Sagai. Sagai? I'm sorry about that, folks, for that horrible pronunciation. Maybe if you can correct me if I'm wrong. A Sagai. I assume it's a almost like a spear, and you can make obviously multiple ones of them, and it requires, I believe, 72 range to wield them. You can also use a shield with them, and the further away from the target you do more damage, the further away from the target when you actually throw it, but the higher damage is at the cost of accuracy. So further away you are, it does higher damage, but it's got lower accuracy. Okay, so that's that. Also, all of the monsters in here, which I'll show the other two in a moment, all of the monsters in here drop something called, and I'm probably going to get it wrong again, excretions? Excretions? I'm sorry, folks. I may have pronounced that wrong again. I apologize. Like something called excretions or something. To that effect, or worse to that effect. And if you combine two of those with mutated vines, you can make bowlers. You know, those you may have seen them on TV, or may have used one yourself for that matter. Something you actually swing in circles and then throw, and it ties itself around legs of an animal to trip them up, trap them. You can actually make them here, and they're only a one use though. They're only one use, and they're able to stop Jadinkos from moving, and the Saggies have a damage bonus against Jadinkos. So really, you'd kinda maybe only want to use the bowlers and the Saggies in this layer. And also the bowlers also, yes, I'll get to that in a minute, thank you. Also have 72 range to wield, and they both have a range attack bonus of 100, so it's pretty nice. Anyway, as that person just said, let's go and explain this. This is a large route. If you cut right into it, which requires 40 wood cutting to do, it's a shortcut to the herbal habitat, and it's a quicker way of actually getting here. So let's go through. Now, as you can see here, I'm actually south of the herbal habitat. The herbal habitat is right up here. Now, if you just wanted a quick way of getting it, just cut the large route. It takes 40 wood cutting to actually do it. So, and you're right at the herbal habitat now, and then that would be a good way of getting here. If you had juju teleport, like spirit pouches, you could teleport to the herbal habitat and just go south and go in from this entrance instead. So that's pretty nice. 40 wood cutting to do that. So let's go into the other chambers. Let's go into the other chamber. This is the second chamber. This one, I don't know if you can see them because it's quite crowded. This one has mutated Jadinko guards, level 145, and they require 86 Slayer to kill them. So there, that's that. That's the second one, and the third level Jadinko, and the highest monster in here, the mutated Jadinko males, level 201, and they require 91 Slayer to kill. Now, the guards and the males both drop the special vine, and the special vine is actually what is needed to make the abyssal vine whip, and I'll get into that in a minute. Purge meet mod ninja. So okay, so they're in there. I can't actually slay them because I'm 88. But yes, the males and guards both drop the vine, but I'll get into the whip in a minute. Now, one more thing I will show you down here is that this offering table here, this offering stone, actually, items appear on it, namely fruit and farming seeds appear on it. When you do things like cut vines, fire make, kill the mutated Jadinkos, the queen, I imagine, will make items appear on this offering table. Seeds appear on here, and special fruit does. Now, the fruit ranges from common fruit all the way up to Zamorak fruit, and they all have strange and pretty good side effects, giving you prayer back, increasing stats, giving you life points back, etc., etc. Now, but be warned, they're only useful down here, because if you try to take higher than common fruit out of the Jadinko layer, see ya. If you try and take higher than common fruit out of the Jadinko layer, it will simply turn into common fruit, and common fruit has no effects at all. So, there you go. That is the Jadinko layer in a nutshell. So let me just move up here, a nice little backdrop. So, lastly, I'll explain the Abyssal Vine Whip. Basically, the Abyssal Vine Whip is made by getting a vine drop from either a mutated Jadinko male or a mutated Jadinko guard, and you combine the vine with the Abyssal Whip and you will make an Abyssal Vine Whip. The Abyssal Vine Whip requires 85 attack and 80 slayer to wield. It does some poison damage and it has a special attack, and the special attack summons vines that will hit your opponents 10 times at 125% of your attack level and 20% of your strength level. So it remains to be seen how good it is. And obviously the burning question on everybody's lips, is it better than a rapier? Will it make Chaotix obsolete? And the answer is quite simply, no, it won't. Because even though the Abyssal Vine Whip is somewhat better than a normal Abyssal Whip, it is still nowhere near as good as the rapier or probably any other Chaotic for that matter. In fact, the slash bonus on the Abyssal Vine Whip, better make sure I don't get logged out, the slash bonus on the Abyssal Vine Whip is 86, which is only 4 more than normal whip, and the strength bonus is 84, which is only 2 more than normal whip. So going by that, if we look at the stats of a rapier, now as I said, the Abyssal Vine Whip has 86 slash, while the equivalent to slash for the rapier is stab, and the stab bonus on a rapier is 94. And you know what, the slash bonus isn't even that bad anyway, it's 78. And as I said, the Abyssal Vine Whip, the Abyssal Vine Whip bonus for strength is 84. On the rapier, Celtic rapier, it is 101. So as you can see, the Chaotic rapier is much better than the Abyssal Vine Whip. Now I'm focusing on rapier because that's what almost everybody goes for when they're dungeoneering the Chaotic rapier. So as you can see, it is much better. It is much better for stab, obviously. It's not that much worse than it in slash, actually, and it is much better for strength. So of course you would definitely not use it over a Chaotic rapier. You definitely would not use the new Vine Whip over a Chaotic rapier. So if you've got a rapier, you're fine, still use it. That's not to say though, if you haven't got a rapier, by all means go and try and get the Abyssal Vine Whip. The vines to actually make the whip are indeed tradable. I don't know how much they're going for, probably a ridiculously high amount because it's new, and however the Abyssal Vine Whip itself is not tradable. But if you've got an Abyssal Vine Whip, you can detach the vine from it at any time and it'll turn back into a normal Abyssal Whip. So there you go folks, that is the entire Jadinko layer in a nutshell, and that is basically the Abyssal Vine Whip in a nutshell also. And now we can finally put the question to whether the Abyssal Vine would be better than a Chaotic to rest. So, there you go, folks. And before I go, I will say that in 2 weeks' time, one of the biggest updates this year is going to be released, and it is definitely going to be a massive update for clans. It is, of course, the Clan Citadels, and there is, of course, a countdown timer for it on the RuneScape homepage. That update is going to be so big, in fact, I will not be able to do just one video on it. So what I'm going to do is, of course, I'll do a vid on it when it's released, the very time it's released. But as you need 5 clan members on to open the portal to the Citadel, I don't know if I'm going to be able to show the Citadel in the first vid, because I don't know if four other of my clan members will be on at the time I do the vid. However, that vid, when Clan Citadels are released, will be the first in a series of progression vids where I will every now and again do a vid to show progress of the Citadel, show what we're doing in it, so show what tier it is, show what features, show the battlefield, etc, etc. So that'll be an entire series of vids, most likely, so look forward to that. Anyway, if you want to speak to me or anyone else in the CC, please join, I should say FC, please join my FC, there I am. And if you liked this vid, and I hope you did, please thumb it up, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you next time, folks. Bye for now.